Hello guys, good evening, welcome. D2CL Season 6 here, I'm Durkit in the JD Studios, and we've got a cracker of a match coming up for you. Best of three, up between NIP and Four Clovers and a Leprechaun. The picks and bans already pretty well underway. They raced through this. They started the ads and stuff, you know, as a third ban popped up. And then all of a sudden, Queen of Pain Undying just get picked straight off the bat. But it's kind of refreshing. New patch hits. We see some new interesting heroes. Ogre and Nightstalker in the first ban phase. They're two very tanky heroes that people have been liking to kind of run and literally run straight into the face of their opponents. But Winterwyvern and Doom, you know, good heavy control heroes there. Doom has been very popular, especially in pubs. But this draft is just racing away. Holy crap. So Quap Undying, Ember Spirit, NIP, they've got, you know, good solid laners, some good aggressive play from Undying. Heroes that can, you know, both be aggressive early on when they get their level 6s, but you know, Ember Spirit, he can farm himself up pretty nicely, while Four Clovers, oh goodness. Oh goodness. Earthshaker, Shadowfiend, Dazzle, and Huskar. So they've got minus armor from the SF Dazzle, they've got lockdown and control teamfight capability from the Earthshaker. And then Huskar, the beast. The absolute monstrosity. They banned out the Axe and the Tusk. And there's not really room here for NIP to pick up something like, you know, a Windranger. They've got their mid, they've got their safe lane, and Undying most likely going to be their offlane hero. Jonas and Fan has been playing some, you know, unusual heroes towards the offlane. Legion Commander. He does still like the Tusk, but Axe as well, obviously banned out there, one of his signature heroes. NIP, where do you go from here? Ancient Apparition is still out there. He's good against Dazzle and Huskar, and I think Seal Kid has been playing that a little bit as well. His Ogre, his AA have been coming to light recently, definitely. But then where does that leave Hanskin? You know, Wisp is still out there. You can do the Wisp Ember combo. It's not too bad, but the Huskar is an annoying hero to deal with, and NIP know this. They've given Iroh this hero a couple of times in the past, and they've had 14-minute wins. And there's the Ancient Apparition. No big surprise, really. Just get the Ice Blast down onto the Huskar and make sure he cannot armlet toggle. Make sure he can't just run himself through a team fight without being held in place and stopped from being the annoying monster he is. Now, fifth bans. What are we looking at? SF mid, Huskar safe lane, Dazzle supporting, and Bambo on the Earthshaker heading towards the off lane. So probably a fifth, or probably a four roll support, sorry, here for 4 C&L. Earthshaker can still go into that role, but Bambo does such a great job on the Earthshaker, get his blink very early on, that I think you just put him up there. While NIP, what do they need? Undying, I feel you need to put in the off lane now because they are lacking in stuns pretty massively. So they need a support, you know, like a witch doctor or something like that. I'm not entirely sure where they head. A Rubick wouldn't be too bad.
Reserve time.
But fifth ban for them. If you're looking for a four-roll hero, something for EGM. Oh goodness. Okay. So they're looking at the Earthshaker being in the four spot and something else, something different coming out for the offlane. Skywrath Mage. So Skywrath Dazzle, got tons of nukes. Very good against the Ember Spirit and the Queen of Pain. That Ancient Seal Silence is going to, you know, keep them on lockdown for a good chunk of the team fights or any ganks or roams they do actually move towards middle lane. NIP. Get a stun. Get a disable. Get something. Something. that's all you need right now. But where do we start to look? Where do you start to look for a hero like Sand King? You go for Sand King for the Burrow Strike, farm up in the jungle. SKAA, it's like an age-old combo. You go back, you know, go back a couple of years, and Chinese teams are pulling this out of the hat all the time.
Reserve time.
No Tusk, you can't pick Earthshaker. You know, these would be really ideal heroes for them. A Lion, it's so rough actually looking at your supports now and realizing there's Huskar, Skywrath Mage. There's so much damage coming out of them. You could go for more teamfight sustain. You know, pick up someone who can heal, can buy a mech, can, you know, keep the ball rolling. Chen. And Chen and Chantress now. They just go for the Witch Doctor. That was the first hero I mentioned. You know, it's just a solid all-round hero. You've got sustain from the Voodoo Restoration. You've got Cask and Death Ward. Death Ward. Against the Huskar is such a great ability. I didn't really think of that one. Really think of that. Oh, oh good, oh goody. Here we go, boys. Error. Let's get back into the game. Come on, Reborn. You know you can do it. Dota 2. Dota bloody 2. Dota start game app is already running. Well, it's not running because it crashed.
As eternal as the moon.
It's definitely
not. To bedrock, I return.
Let's get back into this. I don't think we'll see anything completely out of the ordinary. I think NIP maybe could run aggro try, but I'm not sure how likely that is. You know, you trading farm with a Huskar in the early stages is always risky because of that threat of the 6-7 minute armlet, something like that, from him. But you could do it. But what would that actually leave you with? Let's get back into the game. There we go. There we go. So what would that leave you with? Era solo up on top lane? Against an Earthshaker, we've seen Bamvo actually do very well in that lane. He goes for a 1-3-1 build with Enchant Totem up to 3, and he just starts smacking the Ember Spirit around. So if that 1v1 is actually in place, and they can rotate, you know, Scarath Mage or someone up there, they can actually put a stop to Ember's farming. The aggro try possibility? Undying AA Witch Doctor. Against Huskar Dazzle? It could work. It could work, but Limp's going to get the first bounty rune at bot, as well as Pycat, Shadow Fiend, Saxka. Saxka. I always do this. Cap and I have this really bad habit of adding an extra K in there. Saxa on the Scarath Mage is going to be supporting, running towards mid, harassing, zoning, keeping things going there. And EGM is actually going to be going dual lanes up top with Huskar. So Bambo moves himself down to bot. He's going to be looking at this aggressive dual lane and dying for Jonas some fun. And Sealkid on the Witch Doctor sitting there, while Limpquap Hansken on the Ancient Apparition, and they've already moved this courier all the way around, making sure it doesn't get sniped out. Maybe on the way back, Saxa finds it. He's looking for it. But up at top, yeah, there we go. Era not having a good time at all. And it's rough for him. Sealkid makes the movement up the top to try and fix the lane as much as he can. But Hansken, he's in trouble. Oh no! Pycat misses the raise. If he went for medium and long, he would have had it, but Sucks has not given up. Queen of Pain kills off the Shadow Fiend. But they lose a 2-for-1 trade. Goodness gracious me. A middle lane. NIP off to a pretty roaring start there. Losing your AA, not a big deal. Limp has Bottle Boots. He's close to level 4 as well. Taking the brunt of harassment here, though, and Pycat, a punch and a raise. We're not going to find it. Maybe if he went for that raise there, he could have got it with the Arcane Bolt and finished off Limp. This does leave their lanes a little bit awkward. EGM has Grave. He's forced to pop that onto himself. There's no slight. A level 2 Ember Spirit doesn't have anything really to close the gap down onto that little old Dazzle. So defensive trialings now actually move back up the top. For CNL, they're kind of forced to run their heroes around looking for anything. Oh, Limp. Blink ready, DD in bottle. Pycat, though, salves himself up. Taking a massive chunk of damage there. Just making sure everything's okay. And yeah, I'm alone tonight. The boys have all gone to New York. They're going to be doing ESL 1 New York, holding down the fort. Look at this Bambo. 1v1 against Undying. With his magic stick, he just keeps on stacking charges. He does have to be wary now, though, and, you know, level 5 Undying when he's got the level 3 Tombstone, because Earthshaker, even with boots, is going to be difficult running away from that beast. Limp towers hurt. Pycat's here with his level 2 razors. Looks like he got one off the medium range. Swift ending. This is one of the issues here for NIP. They've got the cask to stun. They've got searing chains to add a little bit of additional lockdown. But they don't have a massive amount to actually keep this Huskar in place. You know, there's no hexes. There's no big stuns. Very, very few team fight control abilities. He It's just going to be the supports moving around looking for anything they can with a chilling touch-up, swift ending. There we go, Cold Feet with a cast, the heal back though. EGM's got a grave available as well. He's going to pop it now, but he's held in place. They're going to try and find a secondary kill here, but no stuns. TP grave out. We'll get EGM back to the fountain. He'll be happy. Keeps himself alive. But the chains timing there from Era. Stopping the grave coming out onto that Huskar. Pretty big, actually. Making sure they secure the kill. Jonas, 17-7. Last hitting away like a boss on this bottom lane. Bambo. 1-1-1 across his build order. Keeping that fourth point for now. Yeah, he might want to go for enchant, might want to go for another point in Fisher, depending on what exactly comes his way. Limp and Pycat doing the dance of death at the middle lane. Limp, though, taking a huge chunk of damage there from a raise. Up at top, though, swift ending. They've got the lockdown here. They've got their levels now. Level 2 in Kask, and that just bounces straight back onto the Huskar. EGM just not strong enough to keep the Huskar alive. They've got plenty of harass, like Witch Doctor, 65 base damage at level 4. With the Chilling Touch, they're actually able to rip through the HP of the Huskar very quickly early on, and I think it's time for lane swapping. It's time to move the Huskar down to bottom lane, because that 6-minute armor I was mentioning, take a look, it's 5 minutes in and he's nowhere near it. Might even have to move himself into, you know, like Tranquil Boots or something like that. At least the middle lane's pretty even for them. Shadow Fiend can always head himself back into the jungle where they have made a few little stacks for him, giving the experience over to Saxa at mid. Having a Scarath Mage with, you know, 3 or 4 points in Ancient Seal, which I feel is where you head here. You know, maybe you go for the second in Arcane Bolt, then you max out Seal to keep the Queen of Pain and the Ember Spirit always on their toes, very wary of what's coming around the corner through the fog. It's the actual roaming out here from NIP. It has been non-existent. They haven't roamed really too much towards middle lane. They had a good bolstered lanes by the AA and the Witch Doctor, but they have made the perfect actual movements across. Limp, silence now with a double raise. He's dead. Pycat doesn't have the mana for it. Doesn't need it. With the DD rune and Saxa there with the Ancient Seal. Up to level 2. Got themselves a good kill on the Queen of Pain. This is the big part of the game now. What does NIP do now that 4CNL have actually switched their lanes? Because Era, he doesn't want to move. He really kind of wants to stay on this top lane and farm away. But against an Earthshaker, who has Arcane Boots already, he's hit level 6, it's not going to be the easiest of lanes to actually pull off. And then you really want to move your supports down to bottom lane, where it's so much easier for the Scarath Mage to move from mid to bot. A lot easier than it is to move from mid to top, let's say. They can get that third man, the fourth man even, a TP from the Shadow Fiend. A Lucky Haste or an Invis Rune? And Pycat could come and crush them. It's like they're both teams. Oh, goodness. They got him. Saxa moves up to top. The TP's too late out from the Witch Doctor. I've seen that coming. I was busy looking at Swift ending down at bottom lane because you're not some fun. He wants in. He's not going to get anything here just yet. Not going to be able to keep that. Oh, here we go. Sonic Wave across. He doesn't keep the Tombstone alive, but baits it out with the Queen of Pain jumping in. And Limp, where are you now? Level 8. Level 8 undying. With the Arcane Boots, I'm guessing you just go for the old standard Arcane's mech, and then you start thinking about your Aghanim Scepter. Oh, Saxa, Era, Seal Kid, they found him. Looping his way through the jungle.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
They want to go down on bottom lane. I mean, this Huskar's not even level 6 yet. He's got himself a Helm of Iron Will, but Armlet's still a good distance away. Stacking happening. And Limp. He wants to kill here, I think. He's got that Shadow Strike down. With a Scream, there's no help coming. And up at top, they've actually managed to pick off Sexy Bambo. Era. The damage output of this Ember Spirit. I only used one remnant, actually, so... His Chilling Touch, the level 2 Cold Feet, Searing Chains to lock him in place was enough. Bambo, kind of prone to using Fissure and things like that to actually farm up. Level 4 in the Fissure now, so it's a pretty hefty mana cost. Now Limp. Aghanim Scepter, right? Got himself. Oh, Yule Scepter. Gonna go for the Yules, I think, here. Up against the Ancient Seal, you do need some kind of defensive item. So that slows down his build, actually, a significant amount. Against Huskar, you'd love to have Ag, just to have that 40-second cooldown on the pure damage ability. Hold it for the Huskar when he's low HP, when his armlet toggling. And just finish him off. Make sure that you can rip him to shreds with, you know, like Death Ward, the Ice Blast, and things like that. Chilling Touch can really take his life total down very, very quickly. This is risky. They know where Seal Kid is. They'll find him as well. Life Break forward. Easy pick off. Swift Ending. He's got enough stick charges to keep himself alive. Jonas, I'm fine. You've got 4 points in your decay. You've got no Soul Rip. You can't actually keep that Tombstone alive, but you don't need to. Limp with a Queen of Pain, blinks forward, EGM TP's with a Grave, but Pikecat turns the fight, he's got nowhere else to go, nowhere to run. Limp cannot blink, and he's gonna get the kill before he goes down. Pikecat stands like a man. Kills off Queen of Pain.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
5-10. An era. He wants to make it 11. He's hasted up, running towards mid. The Ancient Seal, well, you know, it'll slow him down a little bit, make sure he can't chains or slight or anything like that. But there we go. Finished off pretty simply. That was toasty. Bambo, how close are you to blink? Very, very close. And this is the great thing about Bambo offlane Earthshaker. He is always very quick off the mark with that blink dagger. Sitting at 1800 gold now. Gonna get closer and closer. As long as he doesn't die, as long as he doesn't feed off too many more kills. It's always the possibility, especially when he gets jumped up on top. Bambo, Ice Blast, and that's gonna be him survive. No, he turns back into it. Oh, man. Well, Blink Dagger, sorry about that. Bottom lane, Swift Ending's graved up. He turns to fight. He actually has 5 stick charges. He's going to get a decent amount of damage on the Seal Kid, but Voodoo Restoration is not going to be enough. The Burning Spears. Oh, Witch Doctor. Can't last through it. And Limp on this Queen of Pain has been immense. 5-2-2. Absolutely crushing. Mid lane, bot lane. Hasn't made any little, you know... Jumps up towards the top lane just yet, Era. If you have a jumping remnant to get back to, you do. He's actually just going to hold on to it and keep himself running forward, looking for the kill now. With the chains, there's no Ancient Seal for 2 seconds time. Era, there we go. He knows the seal's coming back up. Dazzle denies bot tower. They get the kill over and Undying. But Seal Kid's here. Ice Blast. The cask bouncing back and forth, Swift Ending, even the Sonic Wave. There's a Grave for EGM. He'll be able to TP himself away, it looks like. No more stuns. No more ways to stop him. Over and over again. This Queen of Pain. Using Sonic Wave every time it comes off cooldown and to full extent. Actually getting a bunch of kills. It's been a masterclass on how to deal with the Huskar this game from NIP, honestly. But he's got his armlet now. What can he do with it, though? Can he go looking for kills? Can he go and, you know, 5-man into a tower somewhere? Earthshaker needs his blink dagger. I think that's the one big thing they're looking for. Get yourself that blink. Get yourself S and Y on the Shadow Fiend. Give him some more mobility. Give him that tankiness he needs. We're seeing this sort of... we've seen for quite a while now the switch away from mech on the SF. A lot of it kind of has to do with the offlaners that are picked up. You know, Darkseer loves to build into a mech. There's a bunch of other heroes that, you know, naturally kind of build into the Greaves a little bit later on. The Bounty Hunter in the previous patch as well. But Shadow Fiends nowadays, they've kind of found that with an SNY BKB and then into damage items like, you know, your crits, your Helm of the Dominator for the lifesteal, you can farm Ancients like a TA does. You can flash farm jungle camps and really shove waves out very heavily. But you also offer your frontline tankness as well. You can move up onto the front lines, get into a tier 1 tower, and not really be too pressured. And then you can look for the support items out, like Glimmer Cape and Solar Crest.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
You wanna have some fun? A little bit of trouble here. There's a Witch Doctor behind you, though. Sealed up and limp. You can look for Saxa on the back, the Graves onto Swift Ending. But this Tombstone is actually racking up a bunch of zombies. Yona still hasn't died. And finish off Swift Ending's Huskar. Now looking for more. Bambo gets the Fisher down. One raise available. Echo Slam. Limp. Into the air with the Yule Scepter. Another raise, but he can't blink away. The rest of his team getting the hell out. Undying, I guess he TP back to base.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Oh, as you blink on the Earthshaker.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
This entire time, Era's been up at top lane just farming away. No one's really batted an eyelid, living him up there all on his own. At this point, as a Huskar, you'd love to be heading into the Roche Pit to actually go and solo down Roshan. Get yourself that Agency Immortal. Swift Ending does not have the opportunity for this. No lifesteal. He's got EGM behind him, and I think this Dazzle's basically just going to sit behind the Huskar for the majority of the game. Make sure he can get that Grave off at any opportunity. Smoke time. Who are they going to find in the jungle, though? Do they actually want to go into the jungle? They know that Hanskin is a pretty juicy looking kill up at top. But there's Midas. It's on cooldown. They should be okay. And Bambo reveals himself, reveals the blink as well, jumping up to farm. Nice blast. Can I get launched down to middle lane? Swift Ending. Just gonna farm himself through the jungle. This is a good dodge out from NIP. Era now in the Radiant jungle.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Just look at the sustain they've got. Oh god, Hanskin, he was found. He tried to hide in the trees. It's going to be a tier 1. But look at the sustain they've got through Voodoo Restoration, Mech Arcanes. Is that going to be a Glimmer Cape out from Yonasum Fun? No Aghanim Scepter Undying? No 10 strength decays coming out of him?
Because
that's actually pretty ridiculous. The amount of HP you get from spamming out decays onto a couple of people, Radiant's you get so much health. Under attack. Then you got Limp heading Dyer's into his Aghanim Scepter pretty quickly as well. Attack. This game rests on Bambo's shoulders, it feels. If he gets up to level 11, that's level 2 Echo Slam is going to be pretty important, but not if he's farming that far forward. The rest of his team, nowhere near in position to actually defend him.
Bottom tower is under attack.
And you've got ninjas. Era Battle Fury is still a good distance away, about 1300. Sorry, 1700. Swift Ending. The Tombstone's down. AGM actually TP's in here with Pycat Saxa now looking for Yonas and Fan, but he's got the Cape, he's got Mech, he's got Arcane, the Ice Blast. He's going to fly through here onto a bunch of people. Three hit with the Death Ward just flying out onto them. Swift Ending's Grave, but the Ice Blast's going to last through this. He can't heal himself up enough, and he's just going to pop right there, right then. Limp two man Sonic Wave over onto EGM and Pycat, who winds up Requiem, and the Echo Slam comes in. Bambo catches them with a Fissure across the three. And Limp with Seal Kid, they're actually trapped here. Another blink from Bambo in 3 seconds time can catch another couple of heroes and chance ready. Fisher in a couple seconds time as well, as Hanskin and Seal Kid, they're chased down. Limp and Era though, Searing Chains, Saxka, Pycat as well. But Era, your Flame Guard ripped apart by the physical damage of that wave. And Ninjas in Pajamas. Super aggressive. Great reaction out there from 4CNL. That gives them a good old swing. Look at that. 5,700 experience. Half of it going over to the Dazzle, who nearly is up to level 11 right now. Shadow Fiend. What did he just get delivered? Shadow Blade, fully completed. With his SNY. That delays out the Aghanim Scepter for the Quap. Delays the Battle Fury for your Ember Spirit. Wait a second. Nothing on the... Wait, did he buy something else? Oh, he bought back for that. Holy crap. Oh, I'm not a clever man. They are still a little bit rough around the edges, though. There's 4CNL. 4CNL still have this Huskar who is really under farm. 2-8 and 2. His net worth, you know, middle of the table. An Ember Spirit, you know, scales decently. It's the Shadow Fiend, though. Pycat's SF. This guy's going to be an absolute monster. You can right-click down Era like we saw there with the Shadow Wave, the Weave. The minus armor that 4CNL has is actually absolutely destroying Ninjas in Pajamas. And now another Shadow Blade, Pycat. There's a remnant up for Era, actually behind the tier 2 at top. So unless Pycat gets a good Requiem on top and then hits into him, he's not going to die. So he gives up on the chase and runs himself out. And RP, they still want to go for this bot tier 2 though. Seal Kid. Your medallion. The Arcane Boots, no Aghanims for him. And actually looking at Hanskin, he's got himself the point booster, so Ags isn't actually that far away. Era. Mate, you're in a little bit of trouble. Oh, do they know? Oh, the Ice Blast, I guess, spotted them out on the way past. Era is very defensive there. The ping has come out of pink. Hanskin seems to know that they're up there. A decent amount of catching up to do, though. They had themselves a 3,000 net worth lead. They've controlled Roshan, they've controlled lanes very well. Tier 2 bot has fallen. But Tier 1 mid still standing, and 4CNL, you know, they were at a decent deficit. Actually grabbed themselves back into this game. Now they're the ones applying pressure up at top. The Yule Scepter nearly done over on Bambo. EGM's Dazzle hits level 11, gets himself his urn as well as that medallion.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Still have to worry though about this Ice Blast. It's flying towards mid, but it's too far behind the line. Seal Kid, Glimmer Cape. And the escape from this though. Jonas and Fani drops the tombstone down, but that's just an easy takedown. Oh no, it's not. Swift ending, he can't survive through it. Yeah, got no one to actually back themselves up. Pycat still hit by the Shadow Strike, doesn't Shadow Blade quite in time. The rest of the team's actually roaming themselves down.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
NIP, blink forward, Bambo, echoes one. Get the quick pick, and Ninjas in Pajamas on the really fast retreat out as the cask bounce allows him to TP. Maybe they can find Era though. Maybe they can find Limp. Era's farming this jungle. This is super risky. Ancient Seal, no, oh, he remnants back in time. This Yule Scepter from Bambo, though, it's going to be so vital. Burning through the Flame Guard on Ember Spirit, just removing that out of the fight instantly, and then, you know, in chat, Echo, Fisher. They could lock Era down pretty much instantly. He's still miles away from that Battle Fury. Oh, God, yeah, there's the Quelling Blade. Still got a Broadsword to go. You do have the Greaves up now on the Undying, though, so you can dispel off the Ancient Seal. You can Get himself looking pretty good in the team fights, but Hansken, where are you going? He had an Obs ward. He wanted to Midas a creep and then maybe Obs ward the lane. Get a good lane ward down here somewhere. But there's already an observer watching him. Sees the route across. Swift ending down at bot lane. They want the Ice Blast to fly, but guess what? AA's dead. Sealkid could potentially solo. Could potentially just go down here as a lone hero and kill off Huskar with the help of the Ice Blast. They can actually do that. They've got to rotate two more in. Swift ending. He's in his own jungle. He feels like he's safe. But with the Yules up in the air, he'll drop the Tombstone. And this should be a pretty simple takedown. He can't arm the toggle through this. Surely not. The Death Ward just pumps too much damage into him. That's Limp's Aghanim's fully collected. Oh, reduce cooldown now over on that Sonic Wave. What are we seeing from Pykat now? Is BKB done? Yep. Yeah, buddy. BKB is all done and dusted. There isn't a massive amount of magical damage coming out here. It's just nice to have like a security measure. If you're going in and you want to Requiem from the Shadowblade, to have it against the cask, which is annoying. Searing Chains is pretty devastating if you just get plinked in the head by one of those little things. Then, of course, there's Ice Blast. There's Vortex. It's all the little things that add up. Sonic Wave's still going to go through with the Ice Blast Shatter as well. It's nice to have. And from here, you can just go straight into your big damage item. Start thinking about maybe a helm against an AA Ice Blast. It's not the best little item to go. Satanic into... There's a lot of money to actually save up for and build. Oh, Echo Slam! Era! Dunked and dead! Satanic is a lot of expenditure for what it gives you in this game. So probably things like Butterfly, Scardy, actual effective HP items, maybe even an AC, if they do want to try and bring down towers a little bit faster. Well, the dive up at top, Limp, Fissured. With the Enchant Totem, they're actually going to finish him off and secure the kill. Bambo just TP's himself the hell out there. Onto the tier 2, gets himself away. We did miss, though, the kill over on the Huskar. Undying and Witch Doctor, that Death Ward. Now you're going to start seeing Sealkid build up into the Aghanim Scepter. Everything hangs in the balance, though, and I think the first Roshan fight is going to be of utmost importance for both teams. Getting Huskar the Aegis, or getting this poor Ember Spirit. Era had a very good laning phase. He was 4-2 and 2. Oh goodness, was that just a 2-hit out? I think Hansken just got ripped to shreds there, like 2 or 3 hits from the Shadow Fiend.
Has fallen.
But yeah, Ember Spirit had a good laning phase. He was 4-2 and 2. The defensive tri-lane they ran against the aggro dual lane of Dazzle Huskar, it worked well. It did its job. It held out. And it made sure that Era got a decent amount of farm. But when you look at the Earthshaker being 1500 net worth ahead of your Ember Spirit, that's when you know things really aren't going your way. Swift ending. I'm guessing BKB with the Ogre Club. We've seen a ton of Halberds and just actual just Sanjas picked up just for the strength component of them. But I think BKB here, for the same reason Pykat went for one, and Pykat's the one that takes the Aegis. He is the stronger hero out of the two carries, most certainly. Oh, Bambo. If his Echo was off cooldown, I think Limp just straight up dies there. A couple of seconds off.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Maybe a zoning Ice Blast. Annoy them a little bit. Maybe think, maybe make them think that the aggression's coming, but Jonas and Fan shows himself mid. Limp is just going to run himself across. It's all about securing farm for Era now. Battle Fury is up 28 minutes into this game.
Bottom tower is under attack.
Sexy Bambo, such a player. Shadow Amulet, it's time for games. It's time for fun. He wants to blink Echo onto Hansken. He just makes it all look so easy. Shadow Amulet will give him that little for a bit of safety. Hero's not going to spot him out, and they have no idea. Bambo is actually still hiding up here. Blinks himself over the trees, and is it going to be far enough away? Because Yonasanfan is waiting here. Again, no stuns. No slows, no disables. They rely so heavily on this Witch Doctor. The actual head-on-head 5v5 fight with the Ice Blast, the Tombstone. That if 4CNL start picking at them, you know, prodding, poking, moving themselves around the map like this, they can find the kills they really need, and they know that the AA is dead for another 7 seconds. There's no Ice Blast coming. Can they take this tier 3 in time? Once AA is alive, maybe they back themselves. Yeah, they just back up. There's no real reason actually sticking around. Full Shadow Blade completed for your Earthshaker. Yeah, boys. So what does he go for next? What does Bamvo actually build next? Octarine Core, then Boots of Travel or something like that? I mean, Force Staff is the kind of normal item, the mobility you get from it. But if you've got Yule's Shadowblade Blink, do you need more mobility? I kind of feel that you want to like reduce the cooldown of your abilities, your items, maybe give yourself even more damage. Or the fabled Aghanim Scepter upgrade. Veil of Discord. Something like that. But right here, this is what Nip have kind of resorted to. Farming over in the Radiant Jungle. They've got nowhere to go in their own jungle. Look at the aggression coming out up at top. Yonasanfan, he finds sexy Bambo. Decays. The zombie just pops the Shadow Blade and he's away. Pretty much free just to run himself out. And look at that. Butterfly for that Shadow Fiend. No need to go Satanic or Scardy. Just go for the butter. You know, the ton of right-click physical damage, the Death Ward, the Slight, the right-click attacks out from that Ember Spirit as well. The armor and attack speed you get, great for taking down Taos as well. You can stand up on the high ground. You've got Weave, you've got the good old Solar Crest as well. Unswift Ending does go for the Sanj. I'm not sure if you finish off Halberd. Or you just keep it for the strength. It's an interesting item for Huskar. Pycat still has the second life for another minute, I think. Maybe a little bit less now. Hit by the trail of the Ice Blast. Shouldn't really deter them from going on in. The Undying. Gets his Greaves off, and that Fissure's going to stop him taking a massive chunk of damage as well as the Glimmer Cave. Roll, there we go. Blink Echo catches out Steel Kid, but the Yule Scepter from Limp will keep him alive. Pycat has the secondary life, but he's still graved up. Meanwhile, up at the top end of the fight, the Undying, how many decays can you stack up? Heal yourself? No, he's got no mana. He can't Soul Rip. He Glimmer Capes himself, but he's not going to get away from this. Surely not. The Fissure misses. Pycat, Requiem out. And Limp. You're silenced. You Yules. You Blink. The one charges. He'll keep himself up and running. Well, look at the HP totals over on NRP. They are running out quickly of health. And that Aghanim's upgraded. Ice Blast is going to do a good chunk to Saxa. Swift Ending. Is it time to turn and fight? Pycat is considering this. Maybe they go in back now as EGM heals them up. Seal Kid is the main, taking the main front of damage out from Swift Ending. But down goes the Tombstone. Will do in a couple of seconds' time. EGM graves himself. He's not going to TP. That's a good clear up. They lose their ranged racks, but getting four heroes there is a pretty good trade-off. If only they had a Tombstone just there. Laying that down with three or four heroes escaping out, that would have been pretty massive. Yep. They lose out a little bit. That does give Limp 4,000 gold. I'm picking himself up an ultimate orb. A Hex is going to give them that much-needed disable that they really have been lacking in these team fights. Jonas, Aghanim Scepter time. 10 strength the decay. Here we go. And oh, Seal Kid. Where's your money going? You need that Axe upgrade. For defending high ground, you really, really need that bouncing Witch Doctor ulti. Bambo. See, this is one of the best types of defensive play. You know that Shadowfiend's going to be pushing up, and NIP, if they go for the kill on the SF, you never really expect someone to be sitting in these trees. You'd really expect them to be, you know, kind of meandering behind them, watching for someone in these trees, if the Shadowfiend pushes up a lane. But Bambo, very, very high up. That's what he's looking for. Knows where he can find it as well, and the NIP not falling for the bait. Realizing that maybe there's a bunch of heroes behind the Shadow Fiend, but there really aren't. They're farming jungle. They're actually making the most out of the rest of the map. Bambo, come on, show us. Show us what you're going to buy. Are you going to kill Hanskin? Enchant? Blink Echo? Do you want to expend Blink Echo on this? Not really. MGM, though, is showing himself. With the Weave, Eero should be able to get in range with the Searing Chains, but the creep wave's here. EGM, oh man, if you can grave TP out of this, I will be very impressed. There's no way. The Cold Feet's there, he tries to turn and fight. But there's no chance of survival. But while they lose the Dazzle up at top, 4CNL, they're always making the most of the rest of the map. Pushing themselves down the bottom lane. Roshan respawns in a minute and a half. And with full control of the map like this, NIP. First off, they don't have a great Rosh-taking lineup. Oh, Pycat, has he got this limp? Oh, he walks himself back at just the right time, blinks away, and Requiem will not come to anything.
Look at it go.
But even if NIP managed to get the... get their lanes actually pushed across the river, they don't have the best Rosh-taking lineup, even with a medallion. It'll be really relatively slow. Well, 4CNL can just absolutely demolish that big man in the pit. That's what they're looking for now. Hey, guys. Roshan could be up. Roshan could be alive. But he's not. And NIP, they're actually scared to leave their base. Is this going to be... are they going to go for a smoke play? They don't have a smoke. They are actually just waiting by their tier 3s. A little bit scared, a little bit paranoid. What's coming towards them? Because EGM the Dazzle. It's split push time for Dazzle. The rest of his team's all down a bottom lane. So they think they can fight without him. EGM is not going to be a part of this. A smoke up from NIP. Limp and Jonas, they're both getting their smokes popped as Pycat just goes and kills off AA already. Bambo, Blink, Echo, and here comes the damage. Right click down, Pycat's finally hexed up, and with the Tombstone, maybe they can turn this back around. The Death Ward's good onto Bambo. Jonas and Van heals himself up through this though. The Glimmer Cape and the Sonic Wave kill off Bambo. But it's not enough. Pycat BKBs and absolutely obliterates them all. Era, jump back to your Remnant because you've got nothing to do here. EGM made the long... walk of shame from top lane with a creep wave following him as well, all the way down to bot. No buybacks for NIP. Actually, AA just about gets his with a tick gold. What are we looking at for Undying and the Witch Doctor though? No and no. I need a couple hundred gold to actually pick that one up. So tier 3 glyphed up here. We've got Sonic Wave ready with a Hex and Era, Battle Fury crit. Maybe they can do enough damage over time to this. The Shadow Wave is keeping them up and healthy though. Pycat is solar crested. Just goes straight in onto that range racks. They're not getting the big melee racks here. That's Roshan should be the next port of call. Swift ending cancels out his TP. I think that's a big old indicator saying they're going to go for something extra. They're going to go for that Roshan limp. He's silenced. Going to keep on with the chase. He's got no Hex anymore and he's actually running in here alone. You'll Scepter up on the Dazzle, but that's not going to do anything. Pycat. No Era's there. It's the way to the Remnant. And Roshan should be there for the taking now. NIP have no recourse. They've got to defend top and bot. Era maybe can go and steal this with the Remnant over into the pit. He can see what's going on. But it's always going to be risky. Always going to be risky. This blast maybe open things up. This Swift Ending is clipped by that. Limp jumps in. Huskar takes the Aegis though, and Limp silences Death Ward up on the high ground. Swift Ending. Luckily, you have that second life. But NIP, they've used two of their big ultimates, and now they're going to get hunted, chased. Pycat runs straight into Seal Kid. Four hits. Wham, bam, and down he goes. Beyond Godlike up on your Shadow Fiend. And you're not some fun. You're stuck and trapped. You tried to look for the wraparound, but you just killed off in the end. Limp with the attempt onto Bambo's life, Grave up and heals out. Jake is still alive, and he'll get the stun onto Limp, actually finish him off, and survive through this. He needs another heal. He needs to be healed up, and he will, doubly so. Is there going to be enough damage onto Pycat? Will he drop the Ice Blast, the Shatter? It's so sad to die like that. I'm graved. I'm free. I'm safe. I'm dead.
Dire's top barracks are under attack.
Come on, Bambo. 3,000 gold. You've got to buy something now. Buy a crit. Buy a desolator. Buy a something. Top lane of Axe, Era. You've got to defend this. You cannot let it fall for free. The catapult. Karthi, the catapult. You're just going to slowly but surely kill off the Rax. Until he dies. Noble victory. 79 HP over on that melee Rax, though. Ninjas in pajamas. Last chance saloon. You're going to lose top Rax to Bambo. One hit. Bam. Down it goes. Bot lane. Swift ending. Just going to start whacking away at this melee Rax down in bot. You got buyback on your quap. I guess. You don't want to buyback Queen of Pain, though. Swift ending. He's just going to go straight in for the Rax. He doesn't care if he dies. He's gonna die though. Even with the Glimmer Cape up, he's graved. But he just gets taken out anyway. And they've got themselves two lanes of Rax. No buyback from the Queen of Pain, so ninjas in pajamas, you know, they can still hold on to this. They go and look for exit kills now onto Saxa. Glimmer Cape. Gem spots him. Hey, they don't. No, Sentry. They didn't actually get a gem for themselves. One lane of Rax remaining between 14 and L and victory. They've got no Aegis. They do still have EGM with a ton of gold. Did Bambo spend his on Boots of Travel? Really? That's not a big walloping item. That's not a Bambo item. Where's your Dagons? Where's your E-Blades? Where's your insta-kill onto Hanskin? There it is. Is that going to be a Lotus Orb? Return back the Hex, the Cold Feet, the Cask out as well. And Soul Rip is not too bad either. It's an interesting item. It's like mainly for the Hex, but still you can dispel a couple of cool stuff off. Full Silver Edge for your Earthshaker. Also got Satanic now over on the Shadow Fiend and the Huskar. So Pycat did go back for the Satanic, save himself up a bunch of gold. I'm not sure how useful these are going to be, though, up against that Ice Blast from Ancient Apparition. If they can, you know, if they can kill him with Sexy Bambo like they've been doing in the past couple of fights, and just take the AA out so he can't Ice Blast, then sure. Satanic's going to actually just completely ruin Ninja in Pajamas. Right now, it's Nip just looking to try and hold their own. Not die, not get picked off, not feed. Because one death here. One death on anyone but the Queen of Pain pretty much means it's game. Like, every single hero here is absolutely vital in these team fights. And Bambo, you sneaky little bugger. Shadow Blades forward, pops the smoke, and NIP, their one big move, their sweeping move to try and grasp at straws here back into the game, is just put to a stop.
Visibility.
14L are now in such a great position, they smoke themselves up. They know that they can actually turn this back around. Look for a pick. Look for a kill. Top lane's pushing in, so someone has to go and defend there, and I think that's what Bambo was looking for. Oh, Seal Kid. Up on the high ground, but he will TP himself back. Om nom nom. That's an unbelievable job. Going to have some fun. Slowed by the concussive. Is he going to go for this again? There's an Obs Ward. Do they know? Oh, they have a gem on Steel. Okay, there we go. They know. They know what he's up to. He's been doing it all game long. Looking for the kills up on top lane. But for CNL, they can kind of proxy push. As long as they keep bot and top pushed in, a decent amount, they're naturally going to be pushing it anyway. They can actually just hardcore push down middle lane, take tier 3. Ice Blast. Not ready for another 22 seconds. Pycat says, screw this. You know what? I'm going to stand high ground. The cask bounces back, though, onto Saxa. Poor little guy. And Era really has his work cut out for him here. He's going to spam Slight, keep Remnants back defensively, and really look. Keep himself alive while doing maximum damage out with his Slights as well. The rest of his team, they've got to try and defend out these side lanes as well. And Bambo, guess what? He's looking again. Who's defending bot? Hey, Lip, how you doing? Bambo doesn't want to go for it, though. Keeping his Echo Slam for a bigger fight later on, I guess, with buybacks available here and Defender's Advantage for NIP. Going for a solo Echo isn't going to be that efficient. You get the kill, you force buyback, but then you can't really go and take objectives because you're missing that big teamfight ulti. And heavily relying too much on your Huskar and Shadowfiend Satanics against the Ice Blast is not going to be really where you want to be sitting. All it takes is one mistake. All it takes is one big play. Like if NIP can keep that tombstone up and running, it's going to be difficult. But as it gets later into the game, tombstone, it's a really weird skill. Like early on, you know, the hits it takes to kill it off makes it weaker than it used to be in the early game. But later game, it actually gets a bit stronger. Jump in, Pycat, Sonic Wave down, but the Lotus Orb stops. There's no Hex. Blink Echo, though. Bambo jumps in, and Steel Kid cannot Death Ward. He's made invis by the Glimmer Cape. And he's got that missed percentage chance from the Solar Crest. But Swift Ending makes short work of him and the Tombstone. He's armored up. Satanic ready. He's going to look to jump back in, but Pycat just clearing up houses. Jonas, he actually jumped in there with his Axe upgrade. He's got a ton of HP, but it's not enough to last through. And two dead with no buyback now. NIP, how do you defend your base? How do you defend high ground? You've got Sonic Wave in 10 seconds time. You've got a Hex, but your racks are falling at such a drastic rate here. One last jump in. That's all you can try. That's all you can really try and accomplish. But Hanskin's dead. The Sleight of Fist not going to do enough. And Limp, aggressive jump forward. Limp takes down Saxa, but Swift Ending and Pycat just battling through them all. Dodge out from Era, actually gets him away from the life break. Well played there. And have they done this? Satanic up. Pycat has Satanic as well. They can regen themselves back up to full with that flutter from the butterfly. Pycat, good game's called. There's no defense available from NIP. And that's going to be it. Game one goes the way of four clovers and a leprechaun. Well, that's best of three. Possibly two more games to go, guys. Let's see. Game number two. Who's going to come out on top? We'll be back in a couple of minutes with game two here of this best of three. Don't go anywhere.